Today, let's make a fox face bottle opener ring with the wrench tool in the back. This ring is cast in steel. Let's get started. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. Since it's a Thanksgiving, I'm going to give out this ring at the end of the video. So stay till the end of the video. I'll show you how to get this file and where to send for printing. Starting with this file, you can use any type of animal head outline to making the bottle opener. This is some trick to get it correctly. So let's go ahead to find the image that we want first. You can go to the Google, just typing any type of animal that you would like to have. I'm just typing fox head click art, and you can pick the simple one. So it's what we need to have is just the outline. So pick any of the outline that you think will help you to identify what type of animal that is. Bring in this picture using the command picture, and let's go to the top view. We're going to trace this picture right here. So let's use the control point curve, and you can go ahead to trace. You don't have to trace all over. We just need to have the head, and also we just need to trace half of it. So I'm going to the new layer, coming here, make the layer into the red color so it's easier to see. And you can have it stop it where you think is over the half of them. And then I also want to trace the ear. And also the nose. Alright, and I also want to draw a line to show where approximately I think the center line should be. So I'm gonna draw a line there, holding my shift, and having this line moving down a little bit, and go ahead to trim the anything over the center line. Okay. So now we have that. We don't need the rest of it, the eyes or anything. And again, depends on your design. So I'm going to hide this one first. All right, so now we also need to trim this area off because we want to just have an outline there. And we do want to have everything that's a little bit rounded. So I'm going to use the command fillet corner. And I want to give it the fillet for radius 1. And also fillet here and here. So make it everywhere around it. Now we are done. We are going to mirror to the other side. Right there. And you want to make sure the top is nice and round. The bottom one is going to be covered by the nose. So it doesn't really matter. But you just want to make sure the top is nice and round. And let's go ahead to join them. I'm going to make this ring size very big because it's a men's ring. And so the diameter is going to be 22.2, which is almost like 13 in the size. And plus, it's going to cast in steel, so it will shrink a little bit. So I don't want it to be like too small. And it is a huge ring, by the way. So let's go ahead to make it into a ring. Let's go ahead and use a rectangle tool. And I'm going to make it very wide, like 19. The thickness, let's make it into 2.85. So that's the ring that we have. We want to move this ring from the midpoint to the quadrant. And we also want to round it off the corner first. So let's use the command fillet corners. And let's pick it up for radius 0.5. To make it into the ring, all we need to do is go to the surface, sweep one, and you want to do rail and cross section. Now we need to put the fox face, moving it from the center line, and let's move it, type it 0, so it's right there at the 0 point, and we can move it up a little bit. Now, to decide how big this face should actually work for the cap, we need to understand how big the cap is. So you can go online to find a cap size, or you can just open the refrigerator, get one of the beer out of your refrigerator, and measure it, and then you can model something really simple like this. This is just for our reference to see if that will work. If we go ahead and go to extruded planar curve straight, you're going to notice that it is gonna be really sharp edges, especially when it is meet on the intersection right there, right? So it doesn't look good because it's too sharp over there. So what we can do instead of extrude it straight, we are going to extrude it solid, extrude it planar curve. Instead of going straight, that we want to go taper. You can taper into the size that will go along with this. Maybe the degree is not enough. Maybe I wanted to do 30 degree. So you will have something like this, all right? Notice that when you extrude it, it's almost like 3D scale. And then so it's like too big right now for the top. What you can also do is you can do 1D scale back. So that way I will fit it inside of a ring. And again, what we are looking at is where the intersection is. So if it is too big for you, just go ahead to scale it down. Like that, right? So we need to do a test. Just want to make sure that everything is working, especially if that fit into the cap. So let's do a test first and see if that working. Let's go ahead with Boolean difference, this out of this one. And then we will get this cut right there. We want to tilt it a little bit and then we want to get inside of it. All right, so what you wanted to see is you don't want that the edge is touching. If the edge is touching, that means the piece in the center, it should go a little bit wider. So that means it need to go 1D scale a little bit more, like this way. So you want to judge in between whether it's the shape, is that still maintain the form of the fox, things like that. So we want to get this one in a little bit there. And make sure that, see, this is much better. It's not going to touch. So we can do one more test by Boolean difference. Now we can make this cap get in. You don't have to have a whole cap get in, you just need to have a partial of it. Especially when we have the nose. With this curve, let's go to solid, extruded planar curve straight, and then we'll get something like this. You don't have to have it really long because in the bottom here should catch the cap edge. But it does need a little bit bigger. We're gonna move it here. Or if you want to move it out, that will be fine. Okay, and maybe that stick it too much. We want to scale it down a little bit. Something like this. Okay, now when we look at this, it's really sharp out there. So what we wanted to do is fit it the edges. And I want to fit it for like 0.8 millimeter. It should work. And then, okay. All right, so you may end up this all the time. Sometimes it's because the little things right there, you see that there's two seams right there. And unless you're doing the fit is smaller than this seam, otherwise you're always gonna get the result like this. All right, so I'm going to go back to the stage right here. All right, so you can see that we have a seam there. To fix this issue, you're going to delete this and that will fix the seam. You will no longer have that seam and you're just gonna have it coming back a little bit or coming in a little bit to get to the original shape. Maybe this two, I need to have them coming out a little bit. All right, so let's do one more time. We are going to extrude it straight. And then we are going to make it bigger. moving out here. Maybe going in a little bit. All right, so let's take a look how this fillet will work. Let's go ahead to use the fillet. We use the same radius for 0.8. Now it's working. Now it's not working because 0.8 is too big over there. So I'm going to lower down 0.5 and let's try 0.5 here. All right, so now it's working fine. So this is something, it's great that opportunity I can show you how to fix that fillet issue. All right, so we got the front done and try one more time and try to rotate this and see if it catch. Sometimes, as you can see, it's catch right there. So you kind of need to manipulate multiple times to get, you know, what that is. In the back of the design, I'm going to have some hexagon right here. So I'm going to turn on the grid snap, snapping any point. I will type it 6 as my number. And I can make it like this. And you can gradually changing the size down. Or you can find out what is the standard size and use that standard size to do this. So I'm gonna simply make 3. Just showing you how to do it, but you can make it prettier if you like to. Alright, so with this, I'm going to select all of them and just trim off whatever in the middle and then hit enter and join them. So this is what the wrench is going to be, so you can lock the 3 different sides of the nut over there. So what we're gonna do again, we're gonna move this to the center. So let's use the center snapping into the 0, and that will be there. This one, since we don't have to worry about the cap, so we might able to just go ahead to use extrude it straight. And again, you can extrude it in the angle if that work better for you, but I'm just gonna use the straight at the bottom tool right there. So that is the opening for that. This is basically a trial. You need to tweak a little bit because the ring size different. It's going to change a lot of the diameter right there. I would like to send you a STL printing file for my gift to thank you being fans and writing the comments. You can print this ring in shapeway if you're in the USA. You can print it in the shapeway. They have all different kind of material. This ring has been proof in working. I was printing in steel. They come in different colors. So you have the choice for a black color, brown silver, bronze, gold color, and nickel color. So those color will enhance the personal preference. All you have to do is leave the comment, let me know where you're from. You can type it your city and your country. I have people coming from all over the world. That's really amazing knowing where you're from. I'm in Detroit in USA, so you can type it, "Hi from Detroit, USA," and also subscribe my newsletter, and I will send you an email with this file here. I promise I won't send you junk, only good stuff from me. Thank you for watching, and happy holiday. I'll see you next.